6th. I want the earthquake report. I just looked at it just now, and the time is 1:23 in the past 24 hours, thus being the last hour, there's been 40 earthquakes, okay? Now, that's on the low end. I'm used to seeing a lot more than that on a daily basis. I mean, we're constantly under earthquakes here. So, anyhow, you know, the reason why I look at those earthquakes is because where the Lord said we must be born again into the Spirit, the earth, as it's giving these earthquakes, like a woman, you know, he says like a woman that gives birth, travail as a woman, as it comes up on a woman giving birth. Well, we're about to be born again into the Spirit. Because it says, oh death, where is thy sting? You know, for some of us will escape it. You know, some of us will. But anyhow, I told you on my last video, last night I had a dream where I was in a vehicle and I had a window up above me and it was like evil was trying to get in at, through that window. And what I'm going to read to you in Isaiah chapter 24, starting off at 17, okay? Well, actually, I'm going to start at 16 in on chapter 24 in Isaiah, okay? Judgment for universal sin. But I want to start off reading that one. And anyhow, here we go. Chapter 24, verse 16. From the uttermost part of the earth have we heard songs, even glory to the righteous. But I said, my leanness, woe unto me. The treacherous dealers have dealt treacherously. Yea, the treacherous dealers have dealt very treacherously. Okay, I told you, like, there was a window up above my head, and something was trying to get in, and it was evil. And very evil. It was like breaking the glass above my head. And then I seen a dog inside there with me. And it was like looking at me and like showing its teeth and growling like it wanted to do something to me. But it couldn't. You know, and actually I wasn't really even afraid of it in the dream, you know. The thing that was hitting that glass coming down hard, I was like, whoa, what the heck is this? And then here I opened up that door, even with that thing trying to break in through the glass to get at me. I opened the door to let the dog out, but I had no fear of any of it around me. But everything I was looking at was evil around me, just a lot of evil. And I let the dog out, even though it looked at me grumbling and growling, and I could tell there was something evil in it. And I let it out, I got back into the vehicle, and I ended up waking up from the dream. But anyhow, let me read you this now. I'm at verse 17. It says, fear the pit and the snare are upon thee, O inhabitants of the earth. And it shall come to pass that he who fleeth from the noise of the fear shall fall into the pit. See, there's going to be great noises and earthquakes. And remember what it says in the Bible about great noises? He that fleeth from the noise of the fear shall fall into the pit. And he that cometh up out of the midst of the pit shall be taken up, shall be taken in the snare, for the windows from on high are open. See where it says, for the windows on high are opened? You know, like a snare. So, those are the us that come out of the pit. You know where it says, come out of her, lest you suffer in the wrath that's about to be poured out on it? The windows from on high are open. and the foundations of the earth do shake. The earth is utterly broken down. The earth is clean dissolved. The earth is moved exceedingly. The earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard, and shall be removed like a cottage. And the transgressions thereof shall be heavy upon it, and it shall fall and not rise again. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall punish the host of the high ones that are on high, and the kings of the earth upon the earth. And they shall be gathered together as prisoners are gathered in the pit, and shall be shut up in the prison, and after many days shall they be visited. Then the moon shall be confounded, and the sun ashamed, when the Lord of hosts shall reign in Mount Zion, and in Jerusalem, and before his ancient gloriously. It's Isaiah, okay? Chapter 24. I started off at 16 through 23. Okay? We know something's getting ready to happen. We know it. That dream last night was telling me that evil is about to become unleashed here. It's going to be wicked, man, I'm telling you. But like I said, we can't have any fear of it. Okay, we have to have perfect faith, love, and trust in our Lord Jesus. And if we do that, it's going to be because we know what they said, what was prophesied, was true, which we know it is. We're seeing it all come to life right now. Even those who are scoffing and mocking on these channels constantly, they never let up. Sometimes I'll look at the comments. Well, I always look at the comments to reply to people. But when I see people that are not nice, because it says to comfort one another in these times, okay? So when I see that they're not here to comfort but to cause havoc and chaos, what I do is I immediately block them where I don't see their comments. I can't remove their comments, but they stick around. So a lot of you guys are seeing them all the time, and they just say what they got to say. But I don't have to see it, okay? Because like I said, I'm all about trying to reach out to comfort others, and I like to be comforted as well. Because the times that we're in right now, they're not good, and it's very difficult. It's very difficult. But you see at the end of the trumpet, with that angel above my head, at the end of the trumpet, the white horse and the bathtub. See, I didn't see this at first, when I first seen the angel. I was like, wow, I was in awe with the angel. And you couldn't see that oil anointment at first either. It just kind of appeared over time. Same thing with the other images that are in the back. You know, there's some other things back here. But they weren't there before either. They just kind of appeared later this year, just a few months ago, really. They were never there before. I think we're getting ready to, something's getting ready to happen. We're getting really, really close to it. That's why I always show it, you know. The Lord of hosts, trust me, they can do what they want to do. They're in control of everything. Everything here. And I'm tired. This has been a long time. You know, it's been over 3 years for me. Just my shop, 2 years in my shop when I had my business. I lived in my shop. I actually moved in it because, like I said, things were getting rougher and rougher, worse as time went on. And this is where I've been now for the last 14 months now, you know, kind of living like this. And it's got to be coming to an end, man. I'm ready for it too. I'm super tired. Anybody that, you know, like I said, the Lord's got everybody chosen for different things, and you know, there's a reason for everything. Just got to keep moving on and trusting in the Lord, whatever that is. But we got a cold front coming up next few nights. The 8th, 9th, and the 10th. Well, the 10th is going to get better. The 8th and the 9th are the worst. And anyhow, I'm going to probably go get a room. I found a place where I can go get a room fairly cheap. And the thing that I don't like about those motel rooms is because of the stuff that's gone on in them and the people that have been through there. There's a lot of bad spirits going through those places today, where they've, you know, you've had all kinds of stuff going on in there where people get rooms just to do whatever in them. You know, you got to be careful in those rooms because a lot of demonic spirits. I don't like them, you know what I mean? You can tell, last time I had a room, the lights were going flickering really bad, you know, bright and low, bright and low, bright and low. I'm like, man, you know, sitting in a motel room like that with the lights doing that, you know. But anyhow, you guys, I hope and pray that you guys got something out of that message. Excuse me. What happened was in that dream, even though I seen evil over my head trying to get in, I didn't have any great fear or nothing. You know, because remember what we just read in Isaiah, Isaiah 24, verse 16 through 23, was it? I think it was 16 or 17 through 23. Those that try to flee from the noise will fall into the pit. Okay? So you don't want to be, just be confident in the Lord, okay? Where he says, be at peace. Remember when he came up, that Jesus came up on his disciples and they were in that storm in the ocean? And he said, it's me, be at peace. And as soon as they accepted him into the boat, they were immediately on shore. You know. But anyhow, God bless each and every one of you. And be ready for the coming of our Lord. Because it's not much longer. God bless you.